In this video, we're going to look at the example 9a in your lecture note. Solve the absolute inequality 2x plus 3 less than 5. In order to solve this inequality, we have to use Bessie definitions since it involves only one modulus. From the previous video, we know that we use Golar method to represent the Bessie definitions of absolute inequality. Let's recap. Go means greater than or, La means less than and. So, apply Golar, and since the inequality sign is less than, it means that we have to use La. La means less than and. Thus, absolute of x less than a can be defined as x less than a and x greater than minus a. Therefore, for this question, absolute value of 2x plus 3 less than 5 can be defined as 2x plus 3 less than 5 and 2x plus 3 greater than minus 5. Solve this linear inequality 2x less than 5 minus 3, 2x less than 2, x less than 1. Here, 2x greater than 5 minus 3, 2x greater than minus 8, x greater than minus 4. So, we have two set values of x. In order to find the final answer of x, we know that x lies between these two intersection of x less than 1 and x greater than minus 4. Hence, use real number lines to find the intersection of these two sets. Here is our real number line, x greater than minus 4, x less than 1. Thus, we can see that the intersection of this set is between minus 4 and 1. Therefore, the range values of x that satisfy the absolute inequality of 2x plus 3 less than 5 is x between minus 4 and 1. Moving on to the next question. Let's look at your lecture note example 9d. Solve the absolute inequality 4x plus 1 greater than or equals to 2x minus 5. Since this absolute inequality has one modulus, we use Golar method. For this question, we use Go instead of La because we know that Go means greater than or. So, absolute value of x greater than equals to a means x is greater than equals to a or x less than equals to minus a. For these questions, absolute 4x plus 1 can be defined as 4x plus 1 greater than equals to 2x minus 5 or 4x plus 1 less than equals to minus 2x minus 5. Simplify these linear inequalities. The first one, we get x greater than equals to minus 3. For the second linear, expand the negative first. Then, we will get 4x plus 1 less than equals to minus 2x plus 5. By solving D, we got x less than equals to 2 over 3. Then, for the final answer, we know that the value of x lies in the union of x greater than equals to minus 3 or x less than equals to 2 over 3. Here, by using real number line, we can say that x is all real number, since all values are satisfied for this absolute inequality.